والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. Today inshallah we'll talk about the first rule of نون ساكنة and تنوين. Last time we defined the نون ساكنة and تنوين. What are they and how can we recognize them in the Quran when we see them. Let's keep turning off. Then the of Nun Sakina and Tanween is called Al Idhar. Al Idhar. Adhara in Arabic. Adhara means he made something clear. You make something clear, we call it Adhara, when you make it clear. Fahir. This is my hand in my pocket. I get it out. Azhart yadi. I showed my. Then we say, غطيناها means we covered it. We remove the blanket. We remove the blanket. Then we make it ظاهر means أظهرنا المكتبة. فwhen you make something clear. Regardless, if it's physical or moral, you make it clear. The word Adhara been mentioned in the Quran. In Surah, التحريم, وَإِذْ أَسَرَّ النَّبِيُّ إِلَى بَعْضِ أَزْوَاجِهِ حَدِيثًا. Say, remember when Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the Quran is saying, remember when the Prophet al-Nabi told or kept a secret with one of his wives. One of asarra al-Nabi ila ba'di azwajihi hadithan. Falamma nabba'at bihi wa adhharahu Allah. Then we make something clear. Falamma نبأها به قالت من أنبأك هذا قال نبأني العليم الخبير. Because فلما نبأها به, when he told her that you did this, why became it became clear, وأظهره الله عليه, that Allah سبحانه وتعالى made him to know it. Now everything when we make it clear, then here it's immoral, something is not physical, is not, he didn't see the secret. It's moral that he come to know. The word adhara, this is the basic of idhar. For idhar in general, you make something clear, you make it obvious. Then when we are talking about idhar here, we are talking about sound, that the rule is to make it clear. Versus what? Versus to kill it completely, not to pronounce it. We have this in English. We have some letters in English are written but are not pronounced, right? We call it silent. Silent sound, silent letters. For example, when you, this. This T, is it pronounced? No, it's not pronounced. When you say, we don't say listen. We say listen. For listen, it's written. Physically, it's appearing physically. عليكم السلام. Please keep yourself mute, in a mute mode. This is disturbing the face. Here this letter is T, is not pronounced. We call it silent. Sometimes we kill letters. We kill letter completely. And sometimes we kill them halfway. I'm giving example in English here for people to recognize it, to make it easy. Here, is the T pronounced? No, it's not pronounced, it's killed completely. Sometimes we kill the letter halfway. We don't pronounce it. Look at this in English. What is this? Since. How do you pronounce N? Since. Do we say since in N? You say in a name, for example. Name, you pronounce it, right? Huh? Many. Many, you pronounce it. We don't say many, right? You pronounce it. But here, do you pronounce it completely? Try to pronounce it completely. You say since. No one says since. Say since. 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 You feel some of it, but it's halfway. Fahir is not killed completely. It's killed halfway. Versus when you pronounce letter completely. When you kill the letter completely, we call it in Arabic merging, because you shifted this letter to another one. When you pronounce it halfway, some of it, you feel some of it, we call it ikhfa, hiding. You are hiding this letter, but it's there. But you are hiding the pronunciation of the letter. But versus what? Versus idhar. Versus idhar. Idhar, no. When it comes to idhar, you have to pronounce the letter 100%, completely. For this, what it meant by the rule idhar. We are talking about nun sakina and tanween, right? The rules of nun sakina and tanween. Then where is the position of nun sakina and tanween should be? Should be first, because it will be affected by the letter after, not by the letter before. Why not by the letter before? Because already we pronounced the letter before. Already it's gone. And then we pronounce nun sakina. Fanun sakina should come first. Tanween should come first. Then we will see what is the effect of the 28 Arabic sounds on the nun sakina and tanween. We have 28 Arabic sounds, right? 28. There are 29, but for those who are making differentiation between alif and hams. This is alif, la qala, hams like akhada. When we make these two, they are 29s. If you consider just them, they are one, then 28 Arabic sounds. 28 Arabic sounds versus, for example, in English, I think 26. 26 in English. Some in Urdu, they have more. 34 sounds. It depends on the Arabic. It depends on how many sounds you create. Then the 28, nun sakina will come. Tanween with different types will come. Then we will see a list of 28 letters from alif to the last one, ya. The last one, according to the new criteria of, we have another way, another order, another sequence. But this is the most common one, alif, ba, ta, tha, and so on until you reach ya. But in the old one, no, yeah, it comes here around the beginning. We'll see if the noon is connected to this in one word or two. If the tanween is connected to this, it should be only two words, not one. Because tanween comes at the end of the previous word. It can't be in the middle, as we did explain last time. All of the influence of this schedule, on the nun sakina and tanween is based on the position of nun sakina and tanween and the position of these letters in our sound system. If the letter is close to the nun in our sound system, will make more effect by one way or another. If the letter is more further away from the nun sakina and tanween, then it will have less effect. If the letter in the sound system is far away from nun sakina and tanween, then we might not have any effect. Then let's draw the sound system to see. Here is the sound system. This supposedly to be the lips here. Then we have the throat here. We have the tongue around the area here, and we have the head. Huh? And this is the throat. The sound system starts from here, from this area. We push the air from the lungs and then we start making sounds. Then we'll see here hams and ha, ayn and ha, ghain and kha here close. Then we have qaf, we have kaf, we have here jim, sheen, ya, and so on and so forth from the rest of the letters. Noon, where is the noon, sakina and tanween? Noon, sakina and tanween from this point. From here, you take your tongue against the upper part of the mouth. When you say an, right behind the upper teeth. Right behind the upper teeth. So look at this. Which letters are far away from this point? Jim? No, it's not. For example, meme from here, from the lips. Is it far? No. Ba, here from the lips also. Is it far away? No, it's not far. Which one far away? The letters of the throat. Why? Because we have many stages before we reach this. Noon is here. We have the tongue. We have the top of the throat. Until we reach this. Because they are far away and there is a gap, there is a long distance between these letters and nun sakina, there is no influence of these letters at all in nun sakina and tanwin. And because of this, we come, we say, we pronounce nun sakina 100%. So if the nun sakina is followed by hams, we'll say it an, man, aman. We don't say ma aman. Ma aman halfway. No, we say man aman. The way you pronounce it when you stop, the way you pronounce it when you continue. The way you pronounce it when you stop, the way you pronounce it is different from in kuntum. Why? Because kaf, oh kaf, to here is not too close, but is not too far. In this case, the way you pronounce in, when you stop, you say what? In. But when you continue, huh? Like sense. And in kuntum. Why? We started having some effect. But you still feel the noon? Yes, you still feel the noon. So here is the noon, sakina and tanween, with six letters. The letters of the throat, all of them. We have to pronounce it 100% regardless if it's one word or in two words. One word like yan auna. This is hams. Ha yan hauna. Huh? This is in one word. Ayin. An amta. It's in one word. Ha. Yan hitun, the dig, huh? Yan hitun, noon, ghin, in one word. Take this from me, take this gift. Noon followed by ghin, noon followed by kha. In one word, it came in one word in the Quran. Just one word each. You will not have two words or three words. Like noon followed by ha, we have many. Noon followed by ain, we have many. Noon followed by ha, we have many. But noon followed by ghin, just one word in the Quran. فَسَيُنْغِضُونَ ها؟ إليك رؤوسهم أقولون متى هو قل عسى أن يكون قريبا. This is سورة الإسراء. فَسَيُنْغِضُونَ. You will do it like this. When you do it like this, when they turn their faces like they are in disagreement, فسيون غدونا. فنون followed by غين, and nowhere else in the Quran you can have نون followed by غين. نون followed by خاء in the Quran also one word. المنخنقة. المنخنقة in Surah Al-Ma'idah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about different types of deceased animals that we are not allowed to eat. we are not allowed to eat the one falls from the mountain and died. The one got died in like حرمت عليكم الميتة, the dead one, والمنخنقة, and the منخنقة, the I forgot the word, what's the word when so it's not sophisticated, it's not
slaughter,
no, it's not slaughter, when stop breathing,
is it choking or
yeah, died because of the choking, but there is a word for this,
strangled,
yes. Yeah, the strangled one, yes, والمتردية, the one, والموقوذة, the one we hit it with a rock or we hit it with a stick and died because of this hat. All of them are, فالمنخنقة is one of them, strangled one, okay? This also, in all of these cases, we pronounce the noon 100%. ين هونا, ين أونا, أن عمتا, ين حتون, فسيون غضون, المنخنقة, المنخنقة. This if they are coming in one word. Also if they are coming in two words, we pronounce them 100%. Mm-hmm. Yes, this is 15 minutes.
Yes.
Okay, let me wrap it up. Man, aman. Huh? Man, aman. This is in two words. In the same way I pronounce man, man, aman. Stop, man. Man, aman. Huh? من هو or من هم من عمل نون with عين من عمل and so on and so forth from the examples that is followed by حاء for the sake of time followed by نون غين فا من غيري following by خاء من خير وما تفعل من خير. Same thing we do for نون ساكنة, we do it for تنوين. We do it for تنوين. For example, عليم حكيم, حاء followed تنوين. Here, عليم حكيم. Then we pronounce it 100%. We pronounce it 100%. Then again, what is the simple rule? We call this the first rule related to noon sakinah and tanween is izhar. What does izhar mean? Izhar means to make something clear, to make it clear, to make it obvious. What are the letters of izhar? The letters of izhar is six letters: hamz, ha, ayn, ha, ghain, kha. What is the cause of izhar? It's these letters are far away from the articulation from the makhraj of noon sakina and tanween. How do we pronounce them? We pronounce them 100% as noon sakina and tanween without ghunnah, without nunation, without exaggeration. The normal way we pronounce noon sakina and tanween without exaggeration, we don't say man aman. We pronounce it in a normal way. Then inshallah next time we'll continue these rules and we'll talk about the second rule, which is idgham, the opposite of izhar. What is the opposite of izhar? When we merge completely, when we kill the letter, then we'll talk about idgham inshallah. Thank you for following and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. If any questions or comment, okay inshallah. Thank you.